In this video, we're going to be looking at an interesting expression that you can use to make a suggestion. Ça vous dit? Allez, c'est parti! Bonjour à tous et à toutes et bienvenue. Moi, c'est Marc.
Et moi, c'est Pierre-Benoît.
Welcome back to another episode of Coffee Break French. And this time, we're looking at Karen's question. Karen, our viewer, our listener, got in touch. And Karen asked us how you use the expression ça te dit. Pierre-Benoît, it's an interesting expression, isn't it?
Yeah, not only is it an interesting expression, but it's also a very easy expression to use, Marc.
Très bien.
It's using the verb dire, which means to say. So it's as if the words are speaking to the person. So you invite someone to do something, or you suggest to them that if they would like to do something with you.
Okay, let's look at some examples, and I think that will make things a little clearer. So give us a first example, Pierre-Benoît.
Ça te dit un jus d'orange.
Okay, so ça te dit un jus d'orange. So ça te dit, literally, that to you speaks or says, un jus d'orange, an orange juice. So, what do you think that would mean? Ça te dit un jus d'orange. That to you says an orange juice. It means, do you fancy an orange juice? Does an orange juice speak to you? Something like that. So, do you fancy an orange juice? Would you like an orange juice? And we can simply use it with a noun like that. Ça te dit, and then whatever the noun is. Do you fancy a cheese sandwich?
Yeah, it could be a drink, but it could be food. So, ça te dit un sandwich au fromage.
Un sandwich au fromage. So, ça te dit un sandwich au fromage. Do you fancy a cheese sandwich? But we can also use it in a different way when we combine it with a verb.
Yes, with an action. So, you would need to add the word de and then use your infinitive. I'll give you an example. Ça te dit de voir un film.
Très bien. Ça te dit, and then we've got that very important de in there. Ça te dit de voir un film. Do you fancy going to see a film? Would you like to see a film? Ça te dit de voir un film. And we really need that de in there before the infinitive form. Ça te dit de voir un film. Très bien. Can you give another example?
Bien sûr. Ça te dit de manger au restaurant.
OK, so ça te dit de manger au restaurant. So do you fancy, would you like to go and eat in a restaurant? Or would you like to have dinner in a restaurant? Something like that. Ça te dit de manger au restaurant. OK.
Très bien. Now, ça te dit is quite direct, Mark. OK, it's more like, do you want? I know we would say, would you like? But it's closer to, do you want? But we can use the conditional in French as well to make it more polite, as would you like. So that becomes ça te dirait.
So that's turning our ça te dit, the present tense of dit, of dire, that becomes ça te dirait. So oui. That's the conditional form of dire, ça te dirait. And then your example was?
Ça te dirait d'aller au marché.
Okay, so we're making de into di apostrophe because it's followed by a vowel. Ça te dirait d'aller au marché. Would you like to go to the market? Do you fancy going to the market?
Très, très bien. Now, it's not always with te. We could have other people. We could be inviting a group of people. So ça te dirait could become ça vous dirait.
Très bien. So ça vous dirait, would you all like, so would you all like to, I don't know.
Jouer au tennis.
Okay, so ça vous dirait de jouer au tennis. Would you all like to play tennis? Ça vous dirait, so that we've got V-O-U-S there, ça vous dirait, the plural form. Would you all like to play tennis? But we can also use that vous in another sense, can't we?
Yes, because vous also can refer to one person, not a group of people, just one person. In that case, you're being very polite towards that person. So if I said, ça vous dirait un café, either I'm talking to a group of people, asking them if they would all want to have a coffee, or just one person, if that person would like to have a coffee.
Ça vous dirait un café. Now, we could also say here, ça vous dirait de boire un café.
Oui, de boire, de prendre un café.
So it's the same question, but just asked in different ways. Let's go through each of these one more time. If you can say the French, Pierre-Benoît, I'll say the English. So first of all, ça te dit, these straightforward ones. Would you like an orange juice?
Ça te dit un jus d'orange?
Would you like a cheese sandwich?
Ça te dit un sandwich au fromage?
Très bien. Now let's do the ones with the verbs, the infinitive forms here.
Ça te dit de voir un film?
Okay. Would you like to go to the restaurant?
Ça te dit de manger au restaurant?
Super. And then what about the conditional form here? So again, we're jumping to a conditional now.
Ça te dirait d'aller au marché?
So it means something very similar, but it's just that added level of maybe a little bit more formality, a little higher there. Ça te dirait d'aller au marché. Do you fancy going to the market?
Ça vous dirait de jouer au tennis?
So the plural one, would you all like to play tennis?
And the last one, ça vous dirait un café.
Would you like to have a coffee or would you just like a coffee? Okay, so hopefully this has answered Karen's question. Karen, thank you for sending us your question. And if you have a question like Karen, then simply get in touch with us via coffeebreakquestions.com where you can send us your question. We'll hopefully be able to include your question in a future episode. And of course, if you've enjoyed this video, then make sure you give it a like and subscribe to our channel to get more videos just like this to help you build your language skills.
And if you do have an example using this new expression, ça te dirait, ça vous dirait, ça te dit, ça vous dit, please do not hesitate and post it in the comments.
Très bien. Bon, merci beaucoup et à une prochaine fois.
Salut.